No doubt is going to be a fantastic F1 qualifying session.
When it comes to getting lap time out of this circuit, it's traditionally been about maximizing top speed. Do you simply remove as much downforce as possible, hang on in on the corners and max out down the straights?
Top speed is a key factor for this circuit. Even if you can achieve the same lap time as someone running less wing than you, chances are you'll find overtaking difficult if you have too much drag.
Top 10. Top 10 now. Keep it up.
qualifying finished, it's time to remind ourselves of our top three.
Hamilton, Bottas,
and Sebastian Vettel.
With qualifying wrapped up, we now have our grid lineup for the big race tomorrow. Be sure to join us then for what will no doubt be a fantastic race.
It's time to find out which driver is up to the task of claiming the Chinese Grand Prix. We're here in Shanghai. The ever-tightening turns 1 and 2 will prove tricky in the slippery conditions here at Shanghai, and anyone that slides wide will lose a lot of time getting back on track. Turn 14 should still be the best place for overtaking, but we'll have to see some improvement in the weather before the drivers can take advantage of that DRS assistance. And with me, as usual, is Anthony Davidson. Let's talk about lucky. As with all the drivers at this level, they have a lot of ambition. But Formula One's a daunting step up from any other series, so expectations are high right from the start.
And this is something that has ended the career of many a young driver, as that leap up to Formula One proves to be too much. But luckily, in this case, I'd say they're doing a good, solid job, and the risk the team took in signing them is definitely starting to pay off.
Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, and Valtteri Bottas will line up alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Vettel, Leclerc, Max Verstappen, and Albon, Hülkenberg, Lucky, Perez, and Carlos Sainz, Ricciardo, Butler, Lando Norris, and Grosjean, Kvyat, Raikkonen, Lance Stroll, and Kevin Magnussen. Russell and Lucas Weber completes the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
Start was okay, now stay alert for threats around you. Some information on Kvyat. They have an issue with their car. They're going to be slow. frame could be with us for a while. Light rain conditions for the foreseeable future. Inters seem like the fastest tyre for now. We're in 10th. 10th position. Perez is ahead of you. The gap is less than a second. They're on fresh inters. Signs behind. Less than a second separate you. They're on fresh inters. The gap to the leader is 8.0 seconds. 13. Some time to the car behind. Excess fuel. We'll be back on target soon. Don't wait too long to turn the engine down. at least 20 minutes, maybe more. Light rain is here to stay. Understood, stopping this lap. One stop to go, one stop left in this strategy. Teammate by 4.7 seconds. Exit now. Pit strategy complete. See these tires through to the end now. Great drive. We're really happy with that performance.
That's it for another Grand Prix and a fantastic win for Mercedes. Anthony Davidson, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
Well, I know it's a bit of a boring answer, but the truth is they simply had the best speed package on the day and a driver who knows how to take advantage of that. It doesn't matter how much time you spend poring over the stats and planning strategies if you can't keep the pace, and our winner today showed they could do both.
So after a magnificent race, we can now see the drivers making their way to the podium. Once again, it's the Silver Arrows who take top spot, a well-earned victory for Mercedes. Effect this result has had on the driver's standings. It's a great result for Lewis Hamilton, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Roman Grosjean's my driver of the day. I don't think I've ever seen such a strong performance from him.
Let's move on to the constructors. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. Meanwhile, Renault move up the table with another strong performance this weekend. Well, that's an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.